Hey guys, what's up? We are in Kion. I think it's a crusader free to play as the best class. I'll tell you guys in after this quest why is the best. I think it's the barb and crusader is the king in this game, because it's not everyone has 100% crit chance in this game, so crusader is the king on that. So gonna explain in a bit once we destroy this thing. Let's go. There we go, we done it. And this quest is done as well. Okay. Right. The crusader. Wow. It's almost 49.51. It will be soon. How do you get experience actually in this game without doing anything? I think is the challenge if you get experience mostly, you know. Elder if another way. Okay, that's done. Let's go enter the Court of Whisper. Oh. Let's deliver this scroll. Prepare yourself. All right, here we go. That's done. The dark burden given and a hidden force created. Okay. It's gonna be easy peasy. Okay. Let's go into second life. I have to drop it, I think. And then this, that, this, this, and then this. Look at how much damage I do. I don't even have it like fully geared. This is so cool. Damn, this skill is so overpowered, I think. So overpowered. I think is a crusader the best for the starter for free to play, because holy banner 11.1 second for every ally in your party will gain this increased hit critic chance, hit chance for 100%. and critical hit damage for 135 instead of double the critic hit chance over 100% with ground up 65%. Crazy! Wow! This is amazing. I wonder how, after you keep rank up, I wonder what level is this cause. This is brilliant, actually. It's amazing, you know. And I'm wondering, can you get skill up to, like, if you get like max rank 4, can you able to do like max rank 10, something like that, this to get more benefit. On top of this, hit like a truck with this, and then also condemn hits like a truck with this. So skills are connected, the holy banner, condemn, and then falling sword, because you can shoot 2 times this. It's like a jumping in the sky and landing with the sword. Concentration also damage anything in the circle. That's good as well. And I haven't got really good DPS on this class. This is new one. You know, look at my combat rating. It's not even like high at all. But I'm getting there. I got only crappy gems. I haven't spent any penny on this. I maybe buy some crest to get some good gems on this. It's gonna be a lot of better nuts, I believe. I think it's a potency. I go on here and then armor pen. Always, I can put armor as well. It's crusader supposed to be like a armor class, you know. But we haven't get there. He's not level 80 yet. I mean 60 yet. So once I level 60, then yes, I am thinking about it to do something really amazing with this class. So we gained everything, did we? Yes, 10. There we go. It's gold's increase. I think is the gold is also use your gold wisely. The reason you upgrade your gear, and that way is you get much fun of it. Every time you upgrade your gear is better. Ooh, that's crazy. The graphics is a lot of better than the Diablo 3's. Look at the floor they created. Wow, it's. Some of this game graphics a lot of better than Diablo 3, I believe, you know. It's crazy, man. He's level 49 at the moment, but I haven't done any bounties yet. I have to be level 51 because then it's like works like this. The early in this game what I figured out, what I play with my multi-class, I play multi-class in this game, and my main is monk at the moment. But it will be also crusader as well. Who knows? Because it's a crusader is the king of this game, you know. Because that ability concentration is so cool skill. Holy banner, and if you combine with the holy banner with, I think it's this one. Conduration of light, something it's called, level 50 unlocks, and I am almost there. I haven't done the bounties yet, but I'm gonna stop here to do this one. It takes me there to actually I go there and then come back and do some normal rifts because it gives me experience, and then you get like balance it, I think. That way is a lot of better, but it's what I suggest even myself when I play this game. Honestly, you do not want to play with bounties in early games. You want to do 4 and then stack it, do 4 and then stack it. What I mean, it's stack it actually. I'll explain you guys, because it's lot of new players doesn't have clue about it, because you can stack up to 24, I think, the bounties. You don't want to do early game and bounties because it gives low experience, you know, and you don't, it's so low experience. But when you get level 60, its experience cap goes up. Well, Is it the ideal for to do in 60 or ideal to do it in the low level? Because it makes sense. Then it saves your time by farming as well, you know. I think it's, you don't do it that way, you're going to lose some XP a little bit that way, you know. So then it makes sense because you want to be smart in this game. You don't want to just do blindly things. It's because once you hit level 30 Paragon, trust me, your experience cap going to down a lot. Oh well, if it's so, you need to make sure to save your bounties while you're doing some daily quests or rifts, stuff like that. I'll give you an idea that way as well, because it's that easier for you to level up. Otherwise, it's going to take long time once you hit level 40 Paragon, you know. Oh, it's rolled up pain, trust me. Once with the supposed to be 48, but I am 49 level. That's fine because it like I do like many Zelda riff as possible or challenge riff is possible, because you get challenge riff also complete in challenge riff, as you can see on says on my and I'm on the level 8. I need to do level 7 and 8, and then you get legendaries by doing the challenge riff as well, because I got the puns. If some of you it sometimes like cups, I think is after 6 to 5 the legendaries you get, it's cups so low, they drop it down all the time, so you farm it constant dungeons even with the sets piece. It works like that. After you get like 6 legendaries, never drops. I think is you got booked or issues with dropping rate. The last night I was farming like my monk glow set, you know, hand. It took ages. But, you know, this game crazy all starts with when you know what you're doing. Otherwise, these things are getting harder and harder and you won't be able to hit hard to kill things. My goal was when I play Monk, what I was doing, like I was farming normal level. When I was 60, I said like, this is pointless. I'll go hell one straight. And then once I hell one, I said like, this is pointless. I'll go hell two. Even when I was in level 15 Paragon, I said, this is very hard. But then if you upgrade your gears, then you can kill stuff. And if you party up with people, you know, you can actually party up party finder just like that, and hell one, you need to find the hell twos just like that library, like this one says hell two library is ultimate cool. People level up all the time there, so you know, look at how much damage I do. I don't even like, you know, have a really good gear on me. It's so crazy crusader, you know, so OP. Let's revive this guy. Poor guy is dead. Get up, man, fight for your life. Go. That's it. Now let's go into experience is better than anything. That orange boss right here. Oh my, I'm telling you, man. You get legendary from the orange buff mostly if you haven't reached the cup. So no, I'll help you, man. Experience for me. Another thing to increase your damage, you see shrines right there. You pick the shrines, your damage is huge. And shrines are helping, sometimes you get shields, you know. This is the Mount Zewing, right, however you're saying. This place, you get quite good experience as well. If you know what you're doing, actually, you can stack up to 2000 monster kill strike. You listen to me what I'm saying? Yes, you can kill over 2000 monsters right here. But party has to stay in the same direction, and where is the mobs are respawning, you have to stick in the one area and your party members stay in the one area. What I'm trying to say is, you have a party up and you need to open up the map where you are. It has like a four corner bit. Your teammates take it this corner, the other guys take this corner, the other guys this, the other that take this, and you do the middle. Because when the monsters are respawn, trust me, you'll get so much experience per killing in the party, especially. You see, I already killed these guys and they respawn. Because that's how respawn point works in this game, looks like it, and you take advantage of it because it's good. You know, when you're taking game advantages, a monster's there and a monster's there. I think I am gonna pinpoint this guy and screenshot it if somebody is not kill it. Oh, it's disappeared, isn't it? No, I should go for it. Damn it, somebody is killing it. Thank you. So the orange unique mobs gives you the legendaries, right? You have to keep kill these unique mobs. I think so. I'm gonna take screenshots. I need it because there's a video I'm gonna make about it also. Not like that. Right here. In this location. There you go. Take it. I'll do it later. You see, it's also the Friends Shrine, what I was saying earlier. You get quite good experience through there. And constant respawn. Check out what I'm saying, it's the experience through the hell too, is this place I will be in. So I do sometimes a library, but library is a nerfed, everybody is doing it right there as well. So you can't cycle this and constant, and if you keep eye on the map, you'll see orange mobs. That's the unique mobs, you need to keep kill it. You see what I'm saying? It's the mobs are respawning, keep just like that. And before you're doing it, actually pick the pole of reflection. It's just from the Diablo 2, I think. Diablo 3, sorry. And these little boosts will give you a little bit more experience. And every time you kill it, pick it up, because that's like a faster to level up another way. The faster you kill mobs, the better. Level up faster to get 60 and then switch your gear into hell one. I would straight would not play normal, I would straight go hell one, and then once you level paragon 10 or something like that, if you're defensive or if you support class, you're making whatever you're making, you know, make sure you go hell two after tempa paragon 10. When you party up, actually, it's the people will help you through the progress, you know. And one of these energy globes will cool down your skills. That's really good. There's another shrine, as you can see, fleeing, which is movement speed. And check it up and go down and kill the stuff and come back. And you can repeat this doing in Hell 2 or Hell 1 even. You can do this. And then you go here. Whenever you see blues, the orange unique mobs gives more experience in this game than normal mobs. So don't skip yellow or blue mobs. As you can see, those are magic mobs. You have to kill them because they gives more experience than normal ones. You can see, and you keep kill it over and over and over until you satisfied your experience farming. Again, this is what I have an issue with. I think it's a stupid modem, needs to be changing. I think the orange mobs only respawn right here. That's where it is. Let's go continue the Khazra then. That's how you get the unique mobs, obviously. Several location it will be respawned, and then it has, I believe, it has a limit. Please find him. Azraden is done.
he wants to come party. There you go.
Somebody dead.
Let's get this waypoint just right here. Always the east, yeah. What the heck, two goblin? He's gone.
Returns.
There's the orange. Orange mob right here. I'm gonna take a screenshot again. Two of them, very quick as possible. Oh dear me, come on, quick, quick. I need this on this side.
Go, we killed that one as well.
$45,000 XP. To go to town to sell the loots I have.
materials in this game is very valuable, and you don't want to skip any blues. Whites are always drops, but the blues, yellows are ain't dropping always. This is like a Diablo 4 video, where it is free guy in the app, that portal thing. That's done. Where do we go? Right here. There's a waypoint over there, so I know what it is. So let's go into town and we salvage it. So before that, let's go. Am I going to the right place? Up that way. See, plus I will be back. Let's go salvage these.
What can I do for you?
We're gonna yellow upgrade. Ring? Hmm. Okay. Yellow one socket. Resistance are very bad. 40 resistance.
Do you require magical identity? Well,
need something reforged? Job well done.
Select the auto pickup. I don't know why I done that. Let's go option. I think it's in the display or somewhere. Graphic. Probably general, maybe, yes. Make sure you tick all of it so you don't have to pick up by clicking.